Surprise Devils. What are you doing here?
Hunting down a radar beacon.
A radar beacon? How very interesting. Specific part to these. And calculate 8% that you're looking for the best. If I usually expect it. I thought you might say something like that. Now, how can I put this as simple as possible so someone at your processing speed can understand? In order to find the mechanist, you're going to need more than just my radar beacon. You're going to need access to the facility. I'm willing to provide said access, but you'll have to fulfill two simple conditions. One, you need to get me as far away as you can from these lunatics. And two, find me a new body. Once both conditions are satisfied, I'll gladly provide you with everything you need. Do we have a deal?
Deal.
A wise decision. Once we're at our destination, I'll happily relinquish my radar beacon as a gesture of good faith. Now, I strongly suggest you stop loitering in the middle of a hostile location and get us both out of here at once.
It is I, the Mechanist. I come to warn you of a new scourge who stalks the innocent. It destroys my robot allies who only seek to save lives.
Watch. I'd rather keep myself intact today, thank you. You really are taking the path of most resistance here, aren't you?
Intruder.
Hey.
Where can I... Based on my limited experience with you, I estimate a 0% chance of making it out of here. Not optimal. For it could have an impact on the odds. This has ripped my head off. I demand we rip her head off. It's only fair. Looking for. Thank goodness we are out of that hole. Don't think your job is done. I refuse to cooperate until you provide a body that meets my standards.
Hey.
Yeah.
Here you go, Ada. The final radar beacon. I'll need that head back when you're done.
Of course. Shouldn't take but a moment. There you go. Still in one piece. I'm not sure why you want the head back. All we needed was its radar beacon. Besides, robo-brains are notorious for being, well, a real pain in the neck.
What else do you know about the Meta?
Quite simply, it's the first time General Atomics produced a successful union between organic matter and robotics. The brain is used both as a control unit and a data storage unit, which is far more efficient than using standard circuits. Unfortunately, there were a lot of programming issues with these robots, which caused them to be a bit, shall we say, unhinged. Hopefully, this particular robo-brain will have some of the answers that we've been seeking.
A union of organic matter and robotics? Sounds an awful lot like a synth.
Not at all. The robo-brain was built with a very different design philosophy in mind. General Atomic's intent was to use the human brain to augment the robot's functions. Primarily, to accelerate the decision-making process. Free thought and individuality was never intended. These were expressly built like soldiers, to follow orders without question. The robo-brain's unfortunate tendency towards violence and aggression should be considered more of a malfunction than a calculated decision.
Now that you have the final radar beacon, will it be enough to track down the mechanist's location?
I certainly hope so. I've already started the calculations while we've been having this conversation. That still doesn't explain why you need that head back.
We still need it, Ada. I believe it can help us access the mechanist's facility.
Of course. It makes perfect sense that the mechanist would not only keep its location a closely guarded secret, but would secure it against intrusion as well. I'm terribly sorry. I hadn't considered that possibility at all. I'm afraid when it comes to assisting humans, I'm not doing very well lately.
Don't be ridiculous. If it wasn't for you, we couldn't have gotten this far already.
That's kind of you to say. Ever since I let my friends die in that caravan, I feel like I've been failing in my duties. I chose the route we took the day we were attacked. Perhaps if I'd selected an alternate route, they'd still be alive. Sometimes I wish that Jackson had programmed me with my personality mode set permanently to disabled.
Your personality defines you as an individual. Never let that go.
You're right. All of the good memories I've experienced being Ada would be lost if my personality mode was shut down. I can't afford to lose them. I really think I needed to hear that from someone else. Thank you. Now I've distracted you for long enough. I'll finish up my calculations while you deal with our new friend, Jezebel. Hopefully, she'll be able to grant us access to the Mechanist's facility and we can put an end to this nonsense once and for all.
Heads up.
Looking to lighten your load? selected for me isn't quite invisible, but I have to survive.
I'm sorry you feel that way. It's the best.
Well, it's certain machines around us, devils, and for their amusement. Look, we don't care for each other's company, which we just fucked. So, why don't you ask me anything you wanted to do, and then I'll be on my own.
Tell me everything you know, Mechanist.
The fucking subject, the Mechanist, amazingly a veritable genius. I'm not interested. I'm dutifully with the mechanisms to help the people in wealth for quite a long time.
I knew there was some good left inside that brain.
You call good. I call my primary directive. The mechanist instructed me to seek out and help the people of the Commonwealth. By my calculations, the easiest way to help a human is simply to destroy it. There's no point in prolonging a laughably fragile life. It's the most efficient way to assist them. Any other effort to help tends to result in numerous complex side effects.
I don't think you understand the definition of help.
Help. To give or provide what is necessary to accomplish a task or to satisfy a need. I'm doing exactly as I was instructed, assisting a human to the best of my abilities. Only affords a 25% survival rate. That means there's a 75% chance that despite my efforts, the human I'm assisting will die from something beyond my control. Therefore, it's better to hasten the human's death and put them out of their likely chance of misery than to deplete my limited time. It's actually quite elementary, but given your minimal intellect, I suppose I shouldn't be surprised you don't understand.
And you're going to be a brain pate if you don't tell me how to access the mechanist facility.
There's no need to be rude. It's rather simple, really. In order to gain entry to the mechanist facility, you're going to need to outfit one of your robots with an MSAT modification. I'll upload the plans to your Pip-Boy device. There. I've fulfilled my portion of our agreement. Perhaps I'll remain here for a while and see how things resolve between yourself and the mechanist. Purely for my own amusement, of course. I expect you'll have to tell to return. Then again, be surprised if you recall.
What's up?
I trust you've completed your Jezebel. What you want to
do? I got what we needed.
Good. What do we need to outfit the mechanist facility?
We need to outfit a robot with something called an MSAT? Jezebel gave me the plans.
A custom modification that acts as a mechanist facility. Smart. These are high, the MSAT will be required. Access point, like a robot identification. As for my task, I decrypt the signal radar beacon. Source from sales and service. A front for a large mission. It's time. Have you formulated a plan?
It's time to call the Mechanist.
I'm about the opportunity. I too am curious what the Mechanist would have to say. Now, if you're ready, I believe you have an MC install.
Scan this.
How much service? Let's take a look at what you've got.
Thank you.
Here.
We may.
Got it. Look alive.
Glad to be of service.
Open this. this? Open this.
Running low on components? Thank you.
That's it.
Replacing again. I'm having Fadley fired. I don't care if he is some hotshots kid. He can't do this job, and I'm the one that's got to answer to Rawlings.
Here. Sweet.
Tree.
Hey.
Hope you find what you're looking for.
Thank you.
Over here. My
fair share of my friends will have tyranny for.
Generation capacity exceeded. Now drawing reserve.
Sparks! I'll deal with you myself. My robots.
58%.
Sparks, fire!
I'm not a villain. I just want you to hear me out, face to face.
Very well. I will hear you out, but only for the sake of the Commonwealth. Sparks, with me!
Don't you think it's time you ditched that mask?
You're right.
I'm Isabel Cruz. The Mechanist was just an easy way for me to help the Commonwealth. but all my technical knowledge and all of these resources, and I still failed. How does the Commonwealth have any hope against people like you?
Hey, I'm not the enemy. I'm the one trying to protect the Commonwealth against your robots.
They have taken innocent lives. My friends, they were simple traitors, all dead at the hands of your robots.
That can't be right. Explain yourself.
They're misinterpreting orders. Your own robo-brain said as much. They're saving people by killing them.
Saving by... killing? No. It's... the logic. It's there. I can't now. I was hoping it was the robo-brains, an issue with their memory wipes. But you're right. Their primary directive was flawed.
Now you know the truth. Your robots are dangerous. They had to be stopped.
The hero unknowingly became the villain. I wanted to help the Commonwealth. And robots... oh, I... this place... and figured I could find my part. I accept responsibility. I can't take back what I've done. Or even for it. But this doesn't have to end in violence.
Here to kill you, only to get you and bots to stand down.
Consider it, and you regret this. Promise, none of both will. It's the password. You can use it to shut security protocol. I just rather this place be in your hands now.
I got her to see the truth. She's standing down.
So the Mechanist really was misguided. Did she reveal her motives and reasoning?
The robo-brains were responsible. It was their twisted logic that started all this.
A biological wild card. The unknowns are vast. She had to know the risk she was taking by creating them. Many good people endured suffering and death because of the Mechanist. It's a shame a mind as brilliant as hers allowed such atrocities to be committed.
She's good at heart. She made a mistake. A big one. And she'll live with that guilt.
I believe I have a certain understanding when it comes to guilt. While it's not the justice I had hoped for, it will suffice. Still, I now know that the death of my friends has brought about a safer Commonwealth. Had the Mechanist's robots remained unchecked, I'm certain that damage would have been extensive, halting, if not reversing, any progress that has been made here. With this knowledge, I am finally registering feelings of satisfaction and accomplishment, and I have you to thank for it.
Thank
you. Sure, go ahead.
Oh, good. I just wanted to say I'm really happy, thankful that you've let me stick around here. And in order to show you that I'm done with the past, I want you to have this as a sort of promise, I guess. The Mechanist suit I made.
Thank you.
Welcome. One more thing. A bigger thing. Little robots out there.
Lot.
My communications are down. And I can't call them back, but I can tell you where they are, if you're interested.
Sure.
Great. Yeah. Tracking something. Got it. Looks like only one signal this time. Still, not taking any chances, right?
Look alive.
Glad to be of service.
Thank you.